Today we're going to learn to use imitone with GarageBand. We're using imitone 0.9.2c for Mac. We begin by opening imitone. We can use spotlight up in the corner of our screen and type in imitone to automatically find the copy installed on our Mac. Press enter to open the app. When imitone is open, it should begin responding to our voice. If imitone isn't responding to your voice, see our video about audio setup. Looks good. Next, we'll open GarageBand. If you don't have GarageBand on your Mac, you can get it for free from the Mac App Store. For now, we'll start with one of their preset projects, the keyboard collection. Normally, GarageBand will begin playing notes from imitone as soon as both apps are open. GarageBand has a wide variety of built-in instruments under the library panel. As a starting point, I recommend the synthesizer lead category or the orchestral strings category. Synthesizers give us an especially fun range of sounds to play with. From here, we should follow general advice for using imitone. For example, if we're not an expert singer, it's good to pick a key and scale other than chromatic so that we get the benefits of some pitch correction. It's also good to pick an instrument preset that fits with the kind of instrument we're playing. For example, GarageBand's sync lead has the ability to connect notes together, so we can use the strings or winds preset to affect a legato with our voice. I'm feeling a little jazzy today, so let's find a saxophone. We can use this bar to search for an instrument in GarageBand's library. Hey, look. Okay, we're going to want to pick a preset in imitone that's appropriate for playing the sax. I know just the one. Let's give this a try. That saxophone is playing a little lower than I want. I can use imitone's octave shift to play higher. That's pretty good, but what if it had a more jazzy feeling to it? Imitone scales can change the feel of our music, and a blues scale is perfect for saxophone playing. Let's add a little vibrato control.